观众朋友们好，现在是美国东部时间6月24日，这里是华尔街晚报当日第一期节目。现在我们继续为您带来有关中国以及世界的最新消息。在6月24日上午，河北三河燕郊某一处商业街铺发生了爆炸。根据来自中国媒体的报道，事故调查以及善后工作组表示，事故已造成至少10人受伤，目前伤者已经送医。再为您关注到的是人事变动有关的消息，这里一起来看到的是来自香港《星岛日报》的有关报道。文章介绍，习近平旧部王晓红将任公安部长。文章透露，在去年11月，王晓红升任公安部党委书记，外界普遍猜测他将很快接任部长，而之后半年还是没有消息。文章表示，其实在5月底的时候，王晓红已经主持公安部的工作，并获提名为部长人选，可能在今天就正式或委任成为部长。星岛日报文章介绍，中国共产党牢牢掌握所谓枪杆子和刀把子，所谓枪杆子指的是军队，而刀把子指的则是政法队伍。文章又表示，王晓红是习近平福州旧部，相当于为习近平握紧了刀把子。习近平执政10年，整肃10年刀把子，前几年是所谓的周永康集团，最近则是孙立军集团。星岛日报文章说，按照惯例，公安部长将任国务委员，担任中央港澳工作领导小组副组长，介入港澳事务。据公开资料显示，王晓红是福建福州人，早期在福建工作，2013年的时候调任河南政府省长助理、省公安厅厅长，2014年时升任河南副省长，2015年调任北京副市长，市公安局党委书记、局长，2016年担任公安部副部长。再为您关注到的是习近平7.1可能返港有关事宜。香港当地媒体引述香港当地人士表示，北京领导人在7月1日香港回归25周年时，可能在深圳或者是广州搭高铁来香港出席有关活动。报道表示，现在连接中国大陆的香港西九高铁站内有很多录像器材，包括影音控制台等，工具箱上则写有央视字样。有政界人士估计，7.1当天会有重要国家领导人返港。如果的确如此的话，那么只会当天来回，有可能先到深圳、广州，第二天搭乘高铁来港。香港媒体报道，香港科学院有员工近日收到有重要人员参观的通知，但是具体不知重要人员所指何人。说起香港有关的消息，再来看到的是来自彭博社的独家报道。文章引述知情人士表示，中联办在6月时向在港外国商会询问如何重振香港经济。在6月时，中联办邀请商会负责人参加了会议，就现在在香港和中国大陆的业务所遇到的挑战发表意见。而负责人普遍表示，必须完全结束尽快隔离措施。消息人士表示，中联办和商会负责人之间的会议是重大变化。消息人士表示，当时官员聆听了商会负责人的意见，有其他工作人员在做笔记，但是不知道是否会按照商会负责人提出的建议行事。消息人士表示，这一次会议是以英文进行的，总共内容长达90分钟。而中联办在邀请函列出了5道问题，包括港府如何改善就业商业环境，并且如何着重于大陆业务。
The past 5 decades have been a successful story of friendly cooperation between China and Australia. And this relationship is mutually beneficial in nature.The recent years of our relationship has been a difficult period, undeniably. Nonetheless, China's policy of a friendly cooperation towards Australia remains unchanged. And looking into the future, China-Australia relations enjoy great potential for cooperation and a bright prospect. That's the message that I brought with me.From China. How should I think continue? But more importantly is how we can keep the momentum and put our relationship back on the right track for a sound and a steady development. Come on. is it important to respect each other, respect for each other's sovereignty, territorial integrity, political system, and development mode. These are just some of the basic principles for sound and healthy relations between two sovereign states. The world is colorful and diversified. Democracy is applied in different forms in different countries. And I talked about the potential areas of exchanges and cooperation between China and Australia in the past several decades have fully demonstrated that the nature of this relationship is mutually beneficial. Rather, I'd like to focus on the up-to-the-minute state of China. Our goal is to change our people's life for the better, not to challenge any country or anyone.
And I want to be transparent with our audience. The questions that I'm putting to the end.
There's a lot of areas where China and Australia share common grounds, and there's no historical agreements or fundamental conflict of interest between us. China's development is an opportunity instead of a so-called threat to Australia. And there's every reason for China and Australia to be friends and partners rather than adversaries or even the so-called enemies.
Get started. Look, I'd like to tackle some
coordination and cooperation between China and Australia in international and regional affairs serve the best interests of our two countries and our two peoples, and is also conducive to the global and the regional peace, stability, and prosperity.
Ladies and gentlemen, UTS welcomes freedom of speech on campus. Let me make that clear. That right, however, does not extend to speaking over the top of invited guests and disrupting members of our audience from today's event. So please bear with us for another 10 seconds, and then we can continue on with that open dialogue.
It's my pleasure here, really, to be here for this event. Although there are different views, and I respect the invitation from the UTS and ACRI. It is upon the invitation from UTS and ACRI that I come here to take this opportunity to exchange views with you. It gives me a platform to share my views, at the same time to listen to your views, to listen to your views through your questions posted in advance. And I think it's a good opportunity that we have different views, but there should be expressed in a way that is appropriate.